on slightly further, the similar issues exist on the distance around the Moorhound line. This line has been included in the Mersey travel plan's long-term rail strategy, but also which would incorporate electrification and a new space inside industrial park. This will be a great asset for a lot of residents of Liverpool who are working in the Eastside area. Local campaigners have also for many years been asking for additional stations at Beechwood and Woodchurch. If the electrification were to take place, this line would become part of Mersey Rail's Wirral line, giving excellent access from areas such as Beechwood, Woodchurch and Octoria, and of course onward, a big connection by the land street. In view of all this, I would ask that the Chief Executive make available all evidence held by this council that can be used to support the business case for these improvements, including data on jobs, investment, travel and population in the areas affected. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Anyone else yet? People in the debate, I'll take Chris and Robbie. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I could speak for hours on this, but I'll try to stick to my question. You want to make a difference. That's anybody wants to make a difference.
What's your point?
Just a bit of history. Some people may not know this, my colleague Catherine has alluded to it. But this station has been promised now for well over 30 years. That's actually stage drone. In fact, in 2000, DAA showed Townmeadow Station on drone that. So we convinced the rail that it does. But unfortunately, it still hasn't shown. In the early 2000s, Mersey Travel, in its wisdom, and I do thank them for this, at the time, in its wisdom, bought the land of the old British Rail Company in order to ensure that the land was secure for the station in the future. So the land is available. Councillor Williams also talked about the town and the consultation by Mark McDonald. The figures are quite clear, quite shattering. But when you look at these things that say new stations is likely to attract new users to train service, with over the half, 54% of those who do not currently use the rail terminal claiming they would use a new station once a week or more. Expected use of the new station is also much higher than current usage of the normal rails. Car users get more at the time. And car users claim they would walk to the new station. Overall, 95.6% of respondents said they would walk to the new station. And three quarters of those surveyed, 75.9%, estimated their journey time to the new station to be 5 minutes or less. That's because it's a huge capital area. We have the car lane estate, we have the Millhouse estate, we have South End of the Townmeadow estate. And in fact, one of the reasons for not producing this station, not providing the station in the early 2000s was the council would not fund the footbridge across the outlook in order to gain more clientele. In 2008-2009, the then director of technical services committed to provide funding for that new footbridge. Whether that funding still remains for this council to decide, but it would be an integral part of producing the need for this station. Without it, it's unlikely to move forward. Mr. Mayor, Morton to Nels is the longest stretch of that line of Wirral line without a station. It is in desperate need. This area has grown and grown over the years. The facts in here speak for themselves. Yes, it would cost $7 million for a new station. We know it's a lot of money at the current time, the current financial plan, but it would pay for itself in removing cars from the road and getting people in northwestern Southern Mass, particularly those on the northwestern state, to and from places that they want to get to without the need to use cars. Thank you, Mr.
Mr. Mayor, as indicated by the leader of council, we are intent to support this motion. But just like to raise a few facts on the issue. Work has been ongoing, as Chris alluded to, over a number of years by Mersey Travel, working now on behalf of the combined authority for the lead organisation on transport. But when you look at the figures, we've been looking at the I think that the money that came to the Northwest. my colleague John Salter, who's the lead member for Rail on Metro Travel until recently. I'm aware that they've been done between Metro Travel and the Welsh Assembly. In actually, because our government are the Metro Line lies within the Welsh Assembly region. The work has been ongoing. The work has been ongoing for a number of years, funded by Metro Travel, on a feasibility study and moving forward. So we don't disagree with anything saying, but what we would ask is you, it's your government, your coalition government, do you lobby them and ask them to give us the funding directly? And if it's £7 million, they can say we're funding £7 million for a new station and we'll fund another £100 million for your electrification.